Hey y'all, welcome back. Today we're going to be looking at a new feature in Photo AI called Super Focus. We'll start by opening up an image. As you can see, this image is really blurry. The dog is completely out of focus, even though it was intended to be the subject. While the background should be a little bit blurry, this image is currently unusable. We're going to start by trying some of the sharpening models to see if they can have an impact. We'll try the lens blur model first, and we should also check the motion blur model. We always recommend you start with sharpening models because they're faster to process, and in a lot of cases will do the job just fine. You can see with either model, we are able to bring back some sharpness around the edges of the dog, but most of the flat faces are completely lacking in detail. All of the fur is still very blurry. This image is a great use case for Super Focus. Let's get rid of the sharpen enhancement and we'll open the Super Focus tool. When you're inside Super Focus, the first thing that you'll notice is that the preview works differently. This model is really powerful, so we can't generate a live preview. Instead, just navigate around the screen and click the box on the area that you want to preview. Then, the model will run and you'll get a sample in that area of what the output will look like. In this case, it brought back a little bit of the detail, but maybe not as much as we want. Let's go adjust the controls. We can increase the amount of sharpening that we see by choosing the medium setting. We always recommend you start from low and work your way up to high. Then we'll preview that area again. You can see that a lot more detail came back, but I think we can do even better if we turn on Focus Boost. What Focus Boost does under the hood is actually downsize your image to compress the details and then re-upscales it after Super Focus runs. Surprisingly, this can often result in a more detailed output. With Focus Boost turned on, Super Focus now generates a larger preview and is able to run much faster. You'll also see that we're able to generate a lot more details in the fur here. Based on the preview, we can be pretty confident with these settings, so we'll go ahead and render the entire image. Just hit the render button and Super Focus will start processing. As mentioned before, Super Focus is a very powerful model, so depending on your computer, it may take some time to process. Wow, look at that. Now that Super Focus is done rendering, you can see that it's done some pretty incredible things. See how much detail is now in the fur? It was completely blurry before. You can also see it did a great job of bringing back the texture and all of the facial features. One thing you might notice though, is that Super Focus has created some artifacts, especially in parts of the image that we may not actually want in focus. You can see over here on the telephone pole that it's done some weird things with the writing. Because this image has such a strong depth of field, I think we would benefit by only running Super Focus on the subject. Now don't worry, one of the great things about Super Focus is you can go back and edit the selection after the model is run without needing to re-render. We can just click on the Super Focus button, and from here we can choose to only apply it to the subject. By doing that, we shouldn't see any more artifacts in the background. Instead, we'll just be sharpening the dog. One thing to note, if we do make changes to the model settings here, then we would have to process the results again. In this case, I'll hit apply, and you can see immediately that we have a great result. The dog is completely back in focus. The background remains out of focus, and we've got an image here that is now totally usable. It's honestly pretty amazing what we were able to recover. And that's it. That's the Super Focus feature. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Check out our other YouTube videos and leave us a comment if you'd like to see more.